The story began the way so many do, reading public records. Home Forward, the housing authority for the city of Portland and Multnomah County, posted on its meeting agenda that it was conducting radon remediation. I thought to myself, radon remediation, that must mean there was a problem. What's going on here? I had no idea where the story would take me, but soon it became national in scope. And we reached out to more than 60 housing authorities all across the country in areas that were considered to be at high risk or moderate risk for radon and asked, are you conducting any radon testing? And as of 2018, about 2/3 of them had said, no, we haven't tested our public housing units for radon. Reporters for the Oregonian and our news partners at Advance Local went across the country to 6 cities and knocked on residence doors and public housing, offering free radon test kits. Our reporting not only found that some housing authorities had high levels of radon, but that in some cases, housing authorities knew they had high levels of radon for years and failed to take steps to fix the properties. Radon is measured in picocuries per liter. The standard for mitigation, according to the federal government, is 4. So if you test at or above 4, the federal government recommends that you fix your home. Our testing found levels that were 3 to 4 times as high in certain units. Several properties have tested high here in Portland, including a public housing high rise. One unit there tested over 30 picocuries per liter, nearly 8 times above the federal action level. The tenant who lived there has been in the unit for about a decade and had no idea that radon was in her unit. But renters often don't have the ability to test or don't have the financial means to test or frankly just aren't aware of the issue of radon. And that's particularly true in public housing where people are living below the poverty line often and aren't in a financial position to take matters into their own hands. Housing authorities have told me that they aren't doing radon testing either because they don't have the money for it, or they're concerned if they test and they find problems, they don't have the money to make the fixes. This story exposes uneven protections for some of our country's most vulnerable people. While the federal government has strongly encouraged radon testing and issued stern warnings about the potential health impacts of radon exposure, those warnings have largely been geared towards homeowners. People in public housing are a particularly vulnerable population, and they have yet to receive the same sorts of protections.